A useful feature of pivot tables and the slicers in particular is that the slicer has the ability to control multiple pivot tables at the same time. So for example, here's a pivot table and you'll see I've done it by month. And I've got another pivot table here, and this is by weekday and weekend. And just for completeness, we'll make a third pivot table and this one here we'll do by destination network. So we've got three pivot tables, that's fine, but now we want to create these reports and I want to differentiate between calls and SMSs. So we can use a slicer, so I'm going to go and insert a slicer. There's an item called type, and what we've now got is a call or SMS. So just notice here the total is coming to 2237. Here it comes to 2237. If we change to a call, notice that changes, but if we go to the other pivot tables, notice that they haven't changed. That's because normally a pivot table is standalone. If you make a change here and you want to see calls here, that's fine, but then you have to repeat the process over here. But one of the nice features about a slicer is if I click on it and go to its options, there's something called report connections. And what it's telling us is that this slicer is currently connected to pivot table 1 on the sheet pivot 1. So it's this pivot table here. But what we can do is we can tell it whatever happens here, please make sure it happens to all these pivots. So when I say OK, we can actually check it straight away, and you'll notice that these numbers have changed. Let's go back here and rather look at SMSs. So you'll see that number's changed, but all these numbers now have changed to only look at SMSs. So what's quite nice then is I can come to this, I'm going to cut it, and perhaps I can put it on a navigation sheet here. We'll paste it, and now I know when I get this report, all I need to do is come here, switch on what I want to look at, and I know that all these pivot tables are now showing that. And I can then go back here and choose only SMSs, and the same thing happens. Now that's quite nice, but obviously when we come here, how do we make sure that the person here knows what it is? Well, we can actually repeat the process. When we insert a slicer, we'll make it type, say OK, and notice that it's immediately set to SMS. If I change that to call, that one changes. Notice that my overall one changes, and therefore all of these change. So I can actually go and insert a slicer on each page. And now I can either control it at a globular level, so I'm going to change everything to SMS. When I come look here, they're all SMSs. Or when I come to one of these pivots, I can say, that's interesting, but I want to see what the calls are. When I actually see what's happening here. But the benefit is you know that everything you're looking at is now showing the same item. Again, we could have gone in here and specifically changed this so that it looks at other, it doesn't get affect all the other pivot tables. But this is a very useful feature, especially when you want to create dashboards. They're easy to use, but more importantly, they can control multiple pivot tables and pivot charts.